टाइटंस के बारे में, मतलब कौन से ईयर थे?
शिवम आई स्टार्टेड इन द थर्ड ईयर इटसेल्फ, इन द बिगनिंग ऑफ द थर्ड ईयर. इन माय सेकंड ईयर आई कमेंस्ड विद वेब डेवलपमेंट, एंड बाय द एंड ऑफ सेकंड ईयर आई गॉट एन आइडिया कि हाँ यार डेटा साइंस में ट्राई करते हैं. सो इट्स द थर्ड ईयर यू कैन से व्हेन आई बिगिन, एंड प्रेजेंटली आई एम इन द सिक्स्थ सेमेस्टर, सो यू कैन से इट्स बीन अ ईयर नाउ.
अच्छा, और इसके बेसिस पे मतलब इंटर्नशिप वगैरह लगे, मतलब लग जाते हैं क्या?
ऑफ कोर्स लग जाती है. इन व्हिच ईयर आर यू शिवम?
अभी तो फोर्थ सेमेस्टर में हूं.
इन द फोर्थ सेमेस्टर यू आर? ओके. सो इट्स लाइक डेटा साइंस वोंट टेक लॉन्ग, बट इफ यू सी द स्कोप इट इज हैविंग, the scope it is having right now, so in that way out you will get the internship. It could be even scholarships also exist in the program, and data science ke bahut sare roles and opportunities hote hain. It's not like see the data scientist mein aap jaate ho, uske alawa bhi hote hain, so internship aapko easily mil jati hai. Even in the entire research you can get an idea ki aap kaise start karte ho, kya projects hote hain, kaise aap iske through aage commence kar sakte ho industry ke andar.
Okay.
Yes. Guys, just two more minutes. Possibly our branch counselor will be joining us soon. So, yeah, he's here. So after the introduction, we will start the SIG. Good evening, Parthi sir.
Good evening, Eva. Good evening,
yes,
one and all.
So today we have an SIG that is on the data science, machine learning, and deep learning.
Yeah, that's great. So our respected speaker is over here.
So yes, sir. Like I will be taking the SIG, and after that we will be having an industry expert, and he will be telling us how one is supposed to take it in the industry level. Like how the data scientist work there and how the things goes up.
Fine, great. Please carry on. I am here.
Sure, listening
to your progress.
Thank you so much for your presence, sir. We are starting with the SIG.
All the best.
Thank you, sir. Is the screen visible, everyone? Is the screen visible? Rohit Kaushik, and he is the industry expert presently in the BirlaSoft at the SAP ABAP, and being an ex-intern in the Bharti Airtel and IndiaMart. So let's begin with the SIG. I'm elated to have you all today here in the SIG. So learning objectives, what we are going to learn in the entire SIG. First, let's start with apprehend the field of data science, its impact and importance in the society. What it actually reflects on its application, importance and advantage, why machine learning? Because I have seen like multiple students have a doubt, what is data science, what is machine learning and what is deep learning? So some people used to correlate it and some do get confused ki what this thing is, what is that. So in this SIG, you will get the entire idea what the entire fields is about and how one should proceed with different fields, the algorithms associated with it, and then we will proceed to deep learning. Why to choose data science? It's a very good question, and I would like to ask you all why you are thinking to choose data science. You all are here in the SIG today, so I guess either there should be an inclination towards this field or you must have a plan on the back end. So may I have your responses for the same? Like why data science? Why not web development? Why not UI, UX? Or it could be other fields as well, because multiple are emerging in this era.
I'm not interested in data science. I'm interested in the field of machine learning and deep learning.
Okay.
Like AI and stuff, so that's
So Pratham, are you aware with the fact that data science is possibly the superset of everything? That is, it do include AI. AI is a superset, and data science do have machine learning and deep learning within itself. Are you aware? Okay, that's perfect. So may I have some other responses as well? Why data science? Let's make it as an interactive session. So I could have your views, I could clear it out, and I can give my suggestion for the same. Okay, I guess this much means what we have here. So let's proceed ahead. That is, what professionals say about data science. So data science is a new term, but in the same sense as Columbus was discovered new continent 1,000 years ago. So this statement have an irony in itself. So data science is a field which have been there in the past 4 to 5 years as a booming industry. And still, some people are aware with this, but some people aren't aware with this. So how we are supposed to take this field ahead? So what is data science? Now I need the responses from every single person who is there in the SIG. What is data science? We have these statements here itself, but still, what your perspective and views lies in it? What is data science, guys? You can even write in the chat box. May I have some responses from everyone? What data science is all about? Else I will proceed with the same. Okay, so let me proceed. What data science is all about? Data science is basically a concept to unify the statistics, data analysis, machine learning, and the related methods in order to understand and analyze the actual problem. So data science is something which deals with the computer science, IT, maths, statistics, machine learning, software development, traditional research, and other domains. So if you are going with one field, you need to have knowledge of mathematics, statistics, computer science, and information sciences as well. So let's move ahead. It's a multidisciplinary field in which we have the scientific methods, processes, algorithms, system to extract the knowledge and insight, either be it the structured or the unstructured data. So whenever you are proceeding with any program, with any project, you could have data in two forms. It could be a structured data, it could be unstructured data as well. At first, what we have is, we have the analyst, that is the business administration, exploratory data analysis, machine learning and advanced algorithms, and data product engineering. So after the end of your college, you all will be moving ahead. And usually when you go further in any industry, you won't be getting a job as a data scientist. It will be either be a data analysis, it could be a business analyst. And proceeding with that, you could get it later on. Because data scientist is someone who is aware with all the aspects. That is the data engineering, that is traditional research and machine learning. And in this time being, in these 4 years, you need to be aware about the basics of data science, machine learning, deep learning, or it could be AI if you want to proceed in this field. So what exactly data science include? What's the entire phenomena it is going to carry within itself? The first thing is data science and others, the statistics part is there, the business analysis is there, BI, data management, visualization, machine learning, data mining, and artificial intelligence. So these all terms look like a very big terms, like what this is going to have, what that is going to have. So let's have a project over here so you can get an idea that what we are supposed to take in any project while dealing with data science. So let's have a project. If you have any doubts in between, you can ask for the same. Okay, so here we have a data that is I hope the screen must be visible to everyone.
Yes, it is visible.
Okay, so it's a project that is Arizona Fatal Accidents, in which we will be taking a data set from 2012 to 2016. As I said, data science is all about dealing with data. Even in the PPT, you have seen that it deals with multiple perspectives, that is statistics, business analysis, BI, data management, visualization, and other aspects. So let's have a look how our entire project goes up. Because after that, I will be telling you the libraries and everything which we have used. But prior, let's have a look on the project. So in this project, we have taken a brief in which there is two respective data sets, that is, the auxiliary file layouts, and the first one is the analytical manual and detailed record layouts. At first, you have to take any data set. It could be available open source as well, or you can surf out for the same. Then come the data selection and objective. If you are making any project, there are steps associated with it. So what are those respective steps? Just take the data, make sure you apply all the operations which are needed. So what are the respective operations which are needed? It is the data preparation. So what is data preparation? Here we have taken the data set from this. So it is data.world in which we have taken the Arizona Fatal Accidents 2012 to 2016. So it's a public file. You can get the entire data set from here. And let's proceed in the Jupyter file. We have taken the data sets. It's just a text file initially, just writing in the text cell. Then data selection and objective. What we have done in the data selection and objective, you need to be very clear what you are going to do with this data. So it's an open source data, and without any restrictions, we have taken the data set and just checked out the famous city for accidents. In Arizona, what is the famous accident rate applying, and in which city it happened on our usual chances? So these are the data properties, that is the accident data column details. Just give me a second. Yes, is the screen visible? Apologies, some network issues was there on my end. Just a second. Okay, so what we're doing is we were dealing with the data set and data mining processes. So in which we have taken a data set, at first, what we will do is we will take the importing of libraries. What libraries do exist? So we have Pandas, we have NumPy, Matplotlib, Seaborn, and SkyPy. But before proceeding with the libraries, I would just want to tell you a basic layout that what every single library is all about and how it proceed with. Okay. So here comes the libraries. In Python, if we are dealing data science with Python, the first we have NumPy. So NumPy is a library which deals with the multi-dimensional arrays and matrices in the data collection process. The second one is KayakitLearn. The third is the Pandas. And every single library have its own use and purpose, which we'll be displaying in the project. Then we have the Matplotlib, TensorFlow, Keras. These are pretty much, you can say, advanced libraries. Later on, moving to the tools, we have Jupyter, we have Google Colab, and Thursday the Crystal. So if you will ask me, I will surely prefer Jupyter or Colab to do these projects. It's like Colab can take lots of data in a single go and can even process in its server, but Jupyter is not that good in that respect. Okay, so here comes the project. At first, we have imported all the essential libraries, that is Pandas, SPD, NumPy, NP, Matplotlib, and that's the syntax. If you're importing Pandas as PD, so when you will take the file, that is a CSV file, you have to take pd.read.csv. Guys, if you have any doubts in between, you can ask for the same. I will explain the entire project so you can do it in your own self later on. Then comes the NumPy as NP. The Matplotlib is... Why Matplotlib is used? Can anyone tell me this thing?
Data visualization.
Visual presentation. Yeah.
Very true. And why Matplotlib? Why we haven't used any other library?
It is more reliable than other libraries. More options than other libraries for data visualization.
Okay, so basically you have said it very right. So Matplotlib is used for the data visualization part. Even we have Seaborn as well, but it is the most preferred library because of its ease of use. That's why people do prefer it. So here comes reading the CSV file. So what we have done is we have read the CSV file from the location. The location exists as user, that's the desktop location. So here I have stored two respective data sets, that is the CSV and LSB, and you just have to take the path from the properties and import it directly in the Jupyter file. That's what I have done. As soon you just import it, let's run the cell. So I guess you must be aware that if it's a star, it is running on the server, and when it's get with the number, that means it has been run. Okay, that runs. After that, what we have done is we have just taken the CSV file and put it in the DF1. What is DF1? Why DF? So DF refers to the data frame. What we have done is we have taken the entire data set and just put in the data frame, that is DF1. And if we write DF1, it is going to print the entire file, the entire data set, which we have in the CSV file. CSV refers to comma separated values. I'm just writing the comments in between so that you could get a more clear idea for the same. So reading the CSV file for the consolidated statistical banking, what we have done is we have just read the file first. In the DF2. So here we have two data sets, that's DF1 and DF2. Then printing the DF2 for the same. We have print the DF2, that is a data set. Here comes the respective operations about which I was talking. So we have used Jupyter, it's done. We have the languages, similar languages. It could be R, it could be Python for data platforms we have. But in entire project, what matters the most is data munging. So data munging is all about making operations, cleaning the data, and getting it to the desired output result. So what we have done is we have merged the data, merged pd.merge df1 and df2. DF1 and DF2 are the respective datasets which we have taken ahead, and we have just applied the operation, that is merging, pd.merge, that's a function, and print merged. So merge karne se kya hua? Hamare paas entire dataset aa gaya jo hamare paas DF1 or DF2 ke andar tha. And you can get even a size here, that is zero rows and itne columns.
Eva, I have a question over here.
Yes sir, please.
How do you print in the white space like you have written, merging the respective data frames?
Okay, I agree, sir. So, sir, how I have printed the white space, this white space?
Yeah, everywhere in the white space, you are writing some comments. So, how
yes,
do
sir.
You print that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So basically, if you are asking for the comments, what we have in Jupyter, as here we have taken two data sets and we will be performing the T sets as well. So you can go here in the cells. In the cells, we have options to insert the cell. You can insert a cell above and below. And it all depends on you. For example, I can show it here itself. Here I have inserted a cell. Let's insert a cell above. I have inserted a cell above, and this cell represents as a kernel. That is, sir, जो cell होगा, ये आपके code को output देगा, जो भी आपका code होगा. But हमें क्या करना है इसके अंदर? We want this white space which you are talking about, sir. So is it?
Yeah, sure.
Yes, sir. So, sir, in this, we just have to write it. For example, let's write. So here comes the concept of hashes. For example, I have written hash IEEE-SIG and it comes up as this. So it's a cells mein option hota hai, either insert a text cell or a code cell in cell type. A code cell, a markdown or a raw NB convert. So just insert a markdown cell, and after inserting the markdown cell, just put your content as per your convenience. And if I put a hash here, as much hash I will increase, the heading will get smaller. And as less hashes it will have, the heading will be better. So, sir, you just have to go to cells in cell type, just markdown. That's it. Because a markdown cell is something which is rendered as the HTML1. That is the explanatory text in itself.
Okay, so after printing, if I remove the cell, then the white space will be remaining or it will be deleted as well?
So as this is the thing, I should remove it?
No, just I'm asking. Suppose I have printed importing essential libraries, okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Then if I remove the cell in which I have placed the markdown, then it will exist or it will go?
So it will go. It will go.
So I have to keep the cell in which I am entering the markdown, right?
Yes, sir, you have to. So it's like whenever you're going with a project, try to keep the markdown cell and the code cells different.
Okay.
Yes, sir. So if you will remove it, will go. Well, it is being preferred to keep the markdown cells. Because of the convenience, even if you are giving this code to someone else, so he could get an idea what you have done in the entire code. That's why it is being preferred.
So below, throughout the code, you whatever you are displaying in the white space, that is entered on the top of the your notebook, or just after the cell where you enter the markdown, it will display.
Okay, so I can just show you right here itself. So just give me a second. So let's take this as an example. So just a second. We have this cell and I just want a markdown cell here so that I could write the entire text in it. So let's go to cell. In the cell, I will hit the cell type. In the cell type, I will go with markdown. I have selected the markdown cell. It comes as a markdown cell, but I want this code not to be in the markdown cell, but instead in a normal cell, that is the code cell. So let's remove the code from here. Insert a cell below. And just paste the code. So sir, here I have created a markdown cell. Iske andar we can write anything. Let's take this itself. Because in this project, we will be dealing with visualization in every single part, managing everything. So here is the creation of entire markdown cell. And when we run this cell, it comes in a white space.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
It's absolutely my pleasure. So even I will suggest every single student to keep the markdown cells in your project. It gives you a more good attire when you are going to represent it to someone else, even a to a professor ahead, so it gives a better layout. Okay, so we were going with the operations. What we have done is we have merged the two data sets, that is a DF1 and DF2. After merging, we could get the output here. Now let's move at the data frame equals. What does it mean is, as we have taken two data sets, DF1 and DF2, let's check, even are they similar or not? It could happen that we're similar in our home. So here comes the output as false, because both the data set aren't similar. Then comes the data dimension. So all these are the operation. जब भी आप किसी डेटा सेट को अपने साथ लेते हो किसी भी प्रोजेक्ट के अंदर, तो ट्राई टू गो विद दीज ऑपरेशंस कि इज इट इक्वल, इज इट नॉट, कितने कॉलम्स है उसके अंदर, कितने रोज है, दैट इज द शेप, डॉट शेप, दिस इज द स्केलिंग कंसेप्ट इन द पाइथन, इफ यू आर अवेयर, यू कैन गेट इट इवन इन द स्ट्रिंग इटसेल्फ. देन वी कम टू चेक फॉर द मिसिंग वैल्यूज. चेक फॉर द मिसिंग वैल्यूज कम्स इन द डेटा क्लीनिंग. Because before making any operation, make sure the data is cleaned. Then comes the data cleaning, that is the FELNA. FELNA 0 is, for example, if I checked the missing values and I found that, yeah, these values are missing. So we won't be able to perform any operation because the data set won't be in an equal layout, the orientation. So I have filled it with a 0, the null value at the respective places. Then comes the data frame content head. So what does it head denotes? Head denotes that if I am going to print this out, I will get the respective top 5 values of the head. That is the output, the top respective 5 values. It's the size. Then the exploratory data analysis. What is exploratory data analysis? It is just like setting a specific column or a specific row. I have taken a column that is display max rows and 10. 10 is the size. How much columns or how much rows I need here. So I'm just displaying out the maximum rows with a size of 10 and then displaying it with DF1. So I'm just giving you a layout because within the 2 hours, I can't explain the entire data science to you because it's a huge field, but I can give you a subtle background. That what it is, how a project is made, how you can do. Even after the SIG, you can contact me for any doubt you have or how you can proceed. Then come select D type. D type is your data type. Here comes selecting the D types. And in the D type, I have included number, that is, any single numeric value that is going to be in the data set will be represented here as an output. Because you can see in the respective CSV files. Both the CSV files have a huge data set in which we have numbers, we have strings, we have numeric values, we have like other things as well. So it depends on you, how you're treating the data and what operation you are carrying out within the data. We have frequency, the types, that's the string data, then comes your numeric, and this way it is. So just importing those files and making the specific operations. Okay. Then comes some specific questions. That is, if I have taken DF1, let's take DF1.columns, PD. PD represents your pandas. I have taken PD as pandas and NumPy as NP. Then take the DF1 column, starts with C. So all the things which are going to start with C as my column, that is currency denomination, currency type of reporting country, country party sector, or counterparty country. These all things will be represented because I have written here that starts with C. Then comes your unique. These all are operations, just the basic operations or functions which you can go with. Here is one another thing that as I demonstrated you the data set. In the data set, we were having in the data set, we were having some columns that is named as 2020 Q3, that is the statistical banking data set of 2020. So I just want to rename it. I want that it to be renamed as specific. I want this thing to be renamed as specific and just put it a condition that is in place true. If it exists, it will change it to the specific. Then getting with the specific unique values and max again as it's a maximum specific statistics which exist in it. Going ahead with another function that is dot describe. Describes give you a value that is of your count, mean, standard, minimum, and the percentage along with the maximum. These all are the very basic operations you should try on your own self even after this SIG. You can do it on Jupyter or on Google Colab. I will give you the open source data sets. I have thousands of data sets. Just take it, just insert it as a CSV file as I did. Either as a CSV file or one more idea is there, you can even take the path or either you can go with the data itself, like go with the properties and just put it out and you will get the import file here. Then comes the quotients. Just go with some quotients which you can carry with that. But the main part lies in the visualization, how you can visualize the data. You can see here, we have taken the frequency. Okay, I have to run the cells from the very beginning. In the entire SIG, I will just demonstrate three projects. The first is the exploratory data analysis, which is this project. The second will go as the web scraping. Web scraping is a performance you can keep with the data analysis. And the third is going to be with OpenCV, that is the image processing. Even if you have any doubts in this project, you can ask me here itself. I'm just running all the cells respectively. At any point, you think that I could do in any other way or you have doubts, like how one is supposed to do, you can ask. Plots. Okay, so basically in the visualization part, visualization exists as a histogram. It could be a histogram. It could be a ggplot. It could be a correlation matrix. That's a correlation. That's a heat map. That's a heat map. Aur har kisi ka concept bahut similar hota hai. You just need to go with the basic syntax. What the syntax is, if you're going with the output, just make sure that agar mujhe yahan pe subplots chahiye, so in the histogram, I have to take that AX hist visual bins, and in bins, I have to specify the, like in this, what I need is, with respect to these specific numeric values, I need the histogram to be plotted. And वो चीज़ डेटा सेट के ऊपर डिपेंड करती है कि आपका डेटा सेट है और आप क्या फेस की ग्रिड लेना चाहते हो. That's a correlation matrix. Correlation matrix exists between values. That is these values which are corresponding with these. You can get a correlation matrix and just represent it with a heat map. So that's a heat map with the respective values. But I guess this heat map doesn't look well. So could I have it in square? Of course you can have it in square as well. So just put again the condition, that is the figure size, whatsoever the figure size you want defined as, then SNS heat map correlation square equals to true. As soon the condition becomes true, you will get it. Similarly, I have taken another data set because we have two, that is the LSB and CSB. In the another data set performing the similar things, the consolidated banking statistics, then dealing out with the ggplot, the correlation matrix, the heat maps, and testing. What testing is all about? Testing is about taking hypothesis in our concern, and depending upon a value, you could have a test value. Testing is, you can say, अगर आपको बेसिक ऑपरेशंस करने आते हैं यू कैन गो विद विजुलाइजेशन. आफ्टर विजुलाइजेशन कम्स अ टेस्टिंग. टेस्टिंग के अंदर इट इज अ यू हैव टू टेक अ पी वैल्यू डिपेंडिंग अपॉन क्या आपने इसमें कंडीशन ली है. एंड आफ्टर द कंडीशन यू विल गेट इम्पोर्टिंग द लाइब्रेरीज गेटिंग विद द लोकेशन स्केल साइज टेस्टिंग द कंडीशंस एंड ईदर द हाइपोथेसिस एग्जिस्ट एज ट्रू और फॉल्स यू कैन गेट इट. एंड द हाइपोथेसिस is defined on these two values, that is the statistic and the p-value. Is this project a bit clear to you, like how we can proceed or how things goes up?
I mean, Eva, those who have worked on data cleaning and munging and modeling, they can get it, but those who have not worked in, then they have to execute each and every line of code and understand how we go for data cleaning first, because it is said that for it takes around 80% of the time in data cleaning and preparing the data for modeling. Before you model, you take around 80% of the time of your entire project to prepare the data.
Yes sir.
Someone said that I am interested in machine learning and AI and not data science. So it is important to note that you have to go through the data cleaning process. That is more important. As a data scientist, you will start your journey, and eventually at a later phase you will be recognized as a machine learning engineer or like that. So everything is a part of the job, and we cannot actually avoid this different parts. In industry, what happens that there are different there are very big jobs, so work is assigned in parts, but everyone has to know everything of the entire project. So we have to learn everything. Starting point is you're taking the data, understanding the data, cleaning the data, making the data ready. Then we can go for the modeling and all. That is what I have read and I understand actually. And this year project is a very crucial project. And until and unless we work on this data, we cannot say that we know everything or we understand everything. That is what is my perception.
I do agree, sir. It is. It's like I can just give you a brief overview because we have just 2 hours and I have to explain you every single thing. So I just want it to be in more interactive and practical way out. कि हम कैसे डेटा मंजिंग करते हैं या हम कैसे डेटा को प्रिपेयर करते हैं बिफोर मेकिंग द ऑपरेशंस में क्या क्या होते हैं. वी कैन गो विद मर्जिंग, वी कैन गो विद विजुलाइजेशन, वी कैन गो विद टेस्टिंग. सो आई जस्ट वांट यू ऑल टू जस्ट लुक आउट ऑन द एंटायर प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड आस्क मी आउट दैट आई डिडंट गेट विद दिस पार्ट और दैट पार्ट. सो कैन आई कैन एलैबोरेट दोज स्पेसिफिक पार्ट्स इन अ मोर वे आउट, बिकॉज इवन आफ्टर दिस प्रोजेक्ट आई विल बी डेमोंस्ट्रेटिंग 2 more. So that you could get a more excitement in this field and a basic idea. Because data science is something which is existing and which will emerge for sure in the upcoming 2 to 3 years. And why we all are studying all these technologies, because we all want to get in a decent job after our college. And data scientists do have a huge requirement, I should say this. So it was just a basic project which demonstrate these operations. And let's move ahead with the companies, because what we are looking forward is either be it Amazon, either be it Facebook, Google, or any product based companies, we have requirements. We have requirements of data analyst, we have requirements of business analyst, and you need to be very clear about these perspectives, how to deal with data sets, how to get the data sets within our reach. Because the main concept is to understand it and then go ahead with the requirements. कि हमें चेंजेस क्या करने हैं या कैसे हम मूव अहेड कर सकते हैं. एंड फॉर एवरी चेंजेस वी हैव लाइब्रेरीज, वी हैव मॉड्यूल्स, स्पेसिफिक मॉड्यूल्स फॉर द सेम. बट व्हाई आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट डेटा साइंस और व्हाई वी आर डीलिंग विद ऑल दीज प्रोजेक्ट्स, बिकॉज यू कुड हैव अ लुक दैट द एवरेज डेटा साइंटिस्ट सैलरी इन इंडिया इज नियर टू दिस, दैट इज नियर टू 6 lakh and 98,413. It's a basic approximate idea, and why not? As a fresher, if you can get a salary of near to 6 to 9 lakhs, it's decent. And more important is about your interest. Either it lies in data science or doesn't. Moreover, about the scope abroad, if you're thinking to settle abroad as a data scientist, the average basic pay scale lies this per year. And I should say it is very good. As a data scientist, a data science analyst, as an intern, even a senior data scientist, because in this field, there are more than 10 job requirements you can have. And but the basic thing starts with this itself, that you should know how to make projects, get with more and more projects, and deal out with that. What expectations we have from a data scientist? So from a regular data scientist, we do expect that he or she should know how to analyze the data, how to take care of the modeling statistics, what is the engineering of the prototyping line. So prototyping is about, if you get a project, you should go out. Okay, this is my data set, its requirements are here. Depending upon these requirements, I can make these operations, I can clean the data. Okay, visualization ki requirement hai, so I will do that. Agar nahi hai requirement, so I will proceed with another way out. So you need to have a broad range generalist with a deep expertise. Deep expertise in individual things. Okay, so we are done with the libraries, the NumPy, the pandas, the sky-scit-learn, the visualization part, the matplotlib. TensorFlow is used in neural networks, that is more into machine learning and deep learning, which we will deal out further. Jupyter and Google Colab, okay, that looks good. So some of you are in second year right now, and some of you are just thinking that how should I proceed? How should I proceed with data science? So before proceeding to data science, just go with your basic algorithm solving skills. That is the problem analysis. Agar aapko basic code karna aata hai, you can get with data science very easily. We have two languages, we have R and we have Python for the same. I personally prefer Python instead of R, but it's your wish. So I will just say, just try to go with the basic layouts, and then one good resource which I have found is Free Code Camp. In Free Code Camp, you can get thousands of projects in different fields. The second is Camel is also a platform on which you can try. The third is the GitHub. Try to explore the code, the source codes of different projects. And if you can implement it, that's good to go. If you can't implement it, just lay out, just create a layout in your background, in your mind, ki haan, theek hai, this is a code and how this is running up. It is required. Even if you go with the applications, what are the applications of a data scientist, or how the data scientists are required in different industries? The first is the airline routing planning. They are required there. The second is, even recently, we got to know that we all are getting vaccinated. Are you all aware that in the Apollo hospital, we have the data-driven hospitals? Like, Apollo is one of the data-driven hospitals. Are we aware about that? Guys, I need some interaction. I just want your doubts to be cleared throughout the SIG. Because I know what data science is. But I just want you to proceed with the same field ahead. Please interact. Okay, anyways, let's move ahead. So contribute via competitions. Try to go with the hackathons and different competitions for the data science particularly. And the importance of data science. So what's the importance? Is it something just a one field, I said, because web development is also there, UI UX is also there, IoT is there, augmented reality is there. But why this field? Because this field is something which is associated with most of the fields. Iska use IoT ke andar bhi hai, iska use AR ke andar bhi hai, aapka analysis ke andar bhi hai, aapki problem solving skills bhi enhance hoti hai, and you could get a very good job which we all need somehow. So it was a basic review about the data science, but before proceeding ahead with the machine learning, I would be demonstrating one more project to you. It is about the web scraping, and web scraping is a part of data science. Just once again. What web scraping is? Could anyone tell me? Web scraping, web parsing. No one knows that. You are in second and third year.
डेटा बेसिकली हम स्क्रैप कोई पर्टिकुलर इंफॉर्मेशन इंटरनेट के किसी पर्टिकुलर सोर्स से हम ले रहे हैं.
ओके एंड हम क्यों लेते हैं आदित्य?
मतलब हमें डेटा चाहिए उस तरह का यूज है हमारा तो इसलिए हम लोग स्क्रैप करते हैं. अलग अलग पर्पस वेरी कर सकता है.
वेरी ट्रू यू सेड इट राइट आदित्य. आई अप्रिशिएट योर इंटरेक्शन. सो डेटा Data scraping, web scraping, web mining, parsing, ये सब चीज़ें क्या होती है और इनका यूज़ क्या है? डेटा साइंस में हमारा फर्स्ट यूज़ होता है किसी भी प्रोजेक्ट को बिल्डअप करने के लिए मंजिंग करना, एक प्रिपरेशन करना डेटा की, उसके बाद ऑपरेशंस कैरी आउट करना, विजुलाइजेशन करना, कुछ एल्गोरिदम्स नीडेड है तो वो एल्गोरिदम्स लगाना एंड गेट द डिजायर्ड आउटपुट. द सेकेंड थिंग इज इट्स एप्लीकेशन. Its application also lies in web parsing and the web scraping. So let's take an example here. We all know Amazon.in is a website. Okay, we all are aware. But what if I say I need to scrape? Scrape is just like stealing the data. Stealing the data is illegalized, but you can do it with the company's permission. So if I want to steal the data, and why it is being used? It is being used just to automate the things. Like if it's a website that is amazon.in, I can go to inspect, I can check out ki theek hai how this website is built. Agar main ye code dekhti hu mujhe samajh aa jayega syntax se, theek hai, doc type html hai, humne en likha hai, that is the english language used, uske baad that is the header, body class, isse mujhe idea mil jayega. बट अगर मैं हर एक चीज़ को कॉपी पेस्ट करूँगी इन अ वर्ड फाइल, दैट विल मेक माई वर्क टू बी मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स. सो वाई डोंट वी चूज द स्क्रैपिंग, दैट इज द ऑटोमेटिंग इट. सो हियर कम्स द ऑटो स्क्रैपर्स. हम इसको स्क्रैप कर सकते हैं इसके डेटा को, जो भी हमें डेटा रिक्वायर्ड है. एंड आई हैव स्क्रैप्ड द डेटा फ्रॉम दिस वेबसाइट, दैट इज amazon.in. एंड हाउ वी हैव डू इट, सो इन द स्क्रैपिंग आई हैव यूज्ड ब्यूटिफुल सूप. So Beautiful Soup is again a library and a module which I have used, that is importing BS4 as BS. Already way out hoti hai isko karne ke, but Beautiful Soup is a convenient one, so I will prefer you to go with Beautiful Soup. Okay, so I have this imported Beautiful Soup, that is BS4 as BS. Importing it, it's a syntax. Importing it doesn't mean that ahead, wherever I will be using it, I will just go with BS dot the operation, that is BS dot beautiful source, जिसमें मुझे convert करना है data को scrape करने के बाद. सबसे पहले मैंने import करा, source के अंदर मैंने request भेजी है, URL open, URL के अंदर मैं कुछ भी डाल सकती हूँ, मैंने Amazon करा है, Flipkart डाल सकती हूँ, कोई और website डाल सकती हूँ, जो भी आपको करना है. Then just dot read, reading the file, let's run this code. So Google Colab and Jupyter are two very basic platforms or tools you can use for data analysis, but as a data scientist, Colab is a good one. Like I prefer Colab because isme agar aap bahut sare operations bhi carry out karte ho na, it doesn't lag. It can take lots of data in the server. Okay, so it runs. Then proceeding ahead, I can take the data. मैं scrape कर सकती हूँ data को, but मैं store कहाँ पर करूँगी? I want it in CSV file. CSV is the comma separated values, or do I need an XML? Or it could be even an Excel file as well. मुझे किस में चाहिए? So I need it in this file. That's a file format जिस मुझे चाहिए. So I have taken from source to this file format. Let's run this. That works. Even Parthi sir, as you were asking in the Jupyter, in the Google Colab we have option, either a code cell or a text cell. So isme aap easily text cell bhi add kar sakte ho to make the things happen. Here it's the text cell.
Okay,
here. So just taking as an input, then what we have done is we have taken the title of the page. जो भी हमें चीज़ें import करनी है, जो भी चीज़ें हमें scrape करनी है, उन सबको हम ले सकते हैं and then we can print it. It's a very basic project, just a piece of code you can say, just to give you an idea how the web scraping or application is being performed. So in the title, but वो scrape कैसे कर रहा है? Have you thought about that? हमारे पास website है, हमारे पास source code है, we have the inspect, but how is it scraping it? कुछ देख कुछ तो ऑप्शन होगा ना, वो किस चीज को मैनेज करके स्क्रिप्ट कर रहा है. Does anyone have the idea? Okay, so basically, how is it scraping the data? Let me tell you. We have the tags. We have the head tag. We have the P tag. P denotes the paragraph. Similarly, we have the A tags. A tags denote the anchor and other tags. So, wo jo data ko scrape karta hai, it scrapes with respect to the tags. हमें क्या चाहिए, हमें टाइटल चाहिए. आई गेट विद द टाइटल. आई नीड दैट एवरीथिंग विच इज देयर विद द पी, आई कैन गेट इट. देन आई नीड अ स्ट्रिंग ऑफ द टेक्स्ट, आई कैन गेट दैट एज वेल. इफ आई नीड द यूआरएल, व्हाट इज यूआरएल? यूआरएल आर ऑल एम्बेडेड इन द एचआरईएफ, दैट इज विद इन द एंकर टैग. सो आई जस्ट राइट इट आउट ए, देन द एचआरईएफ यूआरएल डॉट गेट. तो इसमें मुझे जो भी इसके अंदर एंकर टैग्स हो गए, एंकर टैग्स जो मेरे पास लिंक हो गए पूरी अमेजन वेबसाइट के अंदर, वो सब आ जाएंगे. सो ये सारे लिंक्स हैं जो इसके अंदर एग्जिस्ट करते हैं इन amazon.in, एंड यू कैन गेट विद इट. सिमिलरली इफ आई वांट द बॉडी टैग्स, द पी टैग्स, वो सारे टैग्स के अकॉर्डिंग वी कैन स्क्रेप द डेटा. एंड कम्स द टी आर एंड टी डी टैग्स. इन द वेब डेवलपमेंट वी ऑल आर अवेयर दैट द डेटा टैग्स वी हैव फॉर द टेबल टी आर एंड टी डी. तो इसके अंदर जो हमारे पास टेबल के अंदर कंटेंट होगा, दैट मीन्स इस वेबसाइट के अंदर जो भी टेबल्स यूज हुई है, उस टेबल्स के अंदर जितना भी कंटेंट होगा, हम उसे वी कैन गेट विद दैट. गेटिंग दैट एंड अगेन स्टोरिंग इट इन द फाइल लोकेशन. देन कम्स प्रिंट प्रोजेक्ट आइटरेटेड IEEE SIG. So it gets iterated in the same way out. So in this way, you can automate the things. You can scrape the data from any website, and it's an application of data science. So you can try it on your own. Okay, so let's proceed ahead. It's a basic layout of data science. I just get you all know ki aise hum cheeze karte hain. Then comes your machine learning. So what is machine learning? Is anyone aware? किसी ने काम करे मशीन लर्निंग पहले, या सोचा हो आई विल ट्राई विद मशीन लर्निंग? नो वन हैज डन. ओके,
मशीन लर्निंग इज बेसिकली कि जब हम डेटा को हम बेसिकली मशीन लर्न कर रही है, एक सिंपल लैंग्वेज बोले मशीन लर्न कर रही है डेटा के हेल्प से. हमारे जो हम लोग बेसिकली हम लोग अलग अलग प्रेडिक्शंस भी कर सकते हैं इसकी हेल्प से, और ऑटोमेट कर सकते हैं चीज़ों को अगर सिंपल लेमैन लैंग्वेज में बोले तो.
वेरी ट्रू, वेरी ट्रू. हम ऑटोमेट कर सकते हैं, मशीन लर्न कर रही है, बहुत सही बताया आपने. बट हम मशीन को क्यों लर्न करवाते हैं, कोई रीज़न है?
बिकॉज़ अगर मतलब जस्ट टू बेसिकली कि ह्यूमन टास्क को रिड्यूस करती है ये चीज़ की, अगर मशीन अपने आप पे परफॉर्म कर रही है तो.
वेल सेड, या आई अप्रिशिएट, इट्स वेल सेड. सो बेसिकली व्हाई वी परफॉर्म मशीन लर्निंग और मशीन लर्निंग एल्गोरिथम्स एंड ऑपरेशंस. सो मशीन लर्निंग इसलिए हम करते हैं ताकि हम किसी भी एक मशीन को टीच कर सकें हमें क्या करना है. अब टीच कैसे करते हैं, इसके अंदर हमारे ट्रेनिंग मॉडल्स आते हैं. हमें किसी भी मॉडल को ट्रेन करना होता है टू गेट द डिजायर्ड आउटपुट. एंड इवन इन दिस वी हैव डिफरेंट थिंग्स. सो लेट्स गेट विद द एंटायर ओवरव्यू ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग. मशीन लर्निंग, टाइप्स ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग प्रॉब्लम्स. स्टेप टू सॉल्व अ मशीन लर्निंग प्रॉब्लम, व्हाट इज डीप लर्निंग? डीप लर्निंग इज अ पार्ट ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग. एज वी बिगिन विद द SIG फॉर डेटा साइंस. सो डेटा साइंस इज अ सुपरसेट. Then comes your machine learning, which is a part of data science, and then comes your deep learning, which is again a part of machine learning. So there is a hierarchy which you can observe. In the artificial neural networks, then we could have image classification and the CNN, that is convolutional neural networks. So let's get with this. What is machine learning? So machine learning is just a subfield of computer science that gives computers the ability to learn without being explicitly programmed. So इसके अंदर हम computers को explicitly program नहीं करते, but we just train the model and get them know कि ये हमारे पास data है and these are the predictions which are making और ये हमें एक output चाहिए. In this way, we proceed with the machine learning and its algorithms. Then comes a big data era. हमने स्टार्ट करी है सर जी फ्रॉम द वेरी बिगनिंग टिल नाउ वी आर जस्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट डेटा 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 सो व्हाट इज डेटा एंड व्हाई इट इज नीडेड इन टुडेज सिनेरियो इन टुडेज एरा वी कैन सी दैट डेटा इज एवरीवेयर अवेलेबल इट्स अ फैक्ट इट इज अवेलेबल इवन इन द हार्डवेयर वी हैव डेटा इन द डिवाइसेस इन द जीपीएस कैमराज माइक्रोफोन्स डेटा इट इज बीइंग कनेक्टेड टू द इंटरनेट एंड डेटा इज बीइंग स्टोर्ड In the services, be it cloud computing, be it user application. In the user application, we have Gmail, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, all the application which a user being us, perform. So data is being used, but in sab cheezon ke andar machine learning ki algorithms kahan pe use ho rahi hai ya hum kaise kar sakte hai. So before proceeding, machine learning ki jo problems hoti hai, that is pretty much defined into three broad classification. The first is the supervised. The second is the unsupervised and the third is the reinforcement. So what is supervised, what is unsupervised, and what is reinforcement? Let's have a look on that. Supervised. If I take an example, is this a cat or a dog? Are these emails spam or not? So these questions here, these are very clear. Either it is going to be a true or a false. Is it a cat or dog? Yes, it is a cat, or no, it is a dog. So In these examples, we could have a desired output. हमें output दिख रहा है कि या तो वो cat हो गई या dog हो गई because we have asked for options and it is going to be one. So in all the problems in which we could get a desired output, that comes under supervised machine learning problems. In the supervised, it is broadly classified into two categories. The one is the classification and second is regression. So classification क्या होता है? एंड रिग्रेशन क्या होता है सो बेसिकली मशीन लर्निंग इज अ मेथड फॉर द डेटा एनालिसिस दैट ऑटोमेट्स द एनालिटिकल मॉडल बिल्डिंग अगर हम मॉडल बिल्ड कर रहे हैं उसके बाद हमने देखा ठीक है सुपरवाइज्ड है हमें पता कि स्टिल सुपरवाइज्ड है डेटा सेट इज बीइंग यूज्ड एंड वी आर गेटिंग विद एन आउटपुट क्लासिफिकेशन आउटपुट इज डिस्क्रीट वेरिएबल और आउटपुट इज अ कॉन्टिन्यूस वेरिएबल If I'm going with the classification theory or if I'm going with regression, because you all must have heard about all these things from any machine learning engineer or any data scientist. So classification kya hota hai ya regression kya hota hai? So pehle hame data ko analyze karna hota hai. Maine analyze kara, maine dekha, supervised hai. Uske baad main apni khud ki theories apply karungi. Classification mein discrete aayega. I can get with an idea with cats and dogs. In regression, it is going to be continuous. Like the prices or the temperature, which don't have an accurate value, which may change. The second comes to unsupervised. So what is unsupervised? In unsupervised, we don't have a desired output. For example, I want to find anomalies in the credit card usage patterns of my customers. So if you are going to find the anomalies in the credit card usage, you are not going to get a desired output. It could be varied because thousands of customers are there and every single customer is different from another. So a pattern is going to be observed. It comes under unsupervised. So in the unsupervised, basically we go with the clustering theory. So what is clustering? Clustering is all about like hiding the correlation or check out like, okay, this is the group of data set. In this way, we are dealing without and how to reduce the dimensionality in that. So that's how the clustering goes. Even in the simpler way, in supervised, unsupervised, or be it reinforcement, you can have huge projects on individual ones in machine learning because either it is going to be a supervised or an unsupervised or a reinforcement learning, which you will get with. So what is reinforcement? In the reinforcement, the agent interacts with an environment and watches the result. So what does it mean? Ki agent interact karega and you will get with an idea. So isme kya hota hai? For example, let's take environment will give a positive feedback, via a positive or a negative reward signal. So in the task of classification algorithm, it will map out the value as an input value or output value. And we will just check it out. Either the data is going to be continuous or the discrete. And depending upon that, हम environment से check करते हैं, हम kernel से देखते हैं to get an output for the same. कि हाँ ठीक है, ये हमारा environment था और उसके according positive feedback आया, negative feedback आया depending upon our requirements. Guys, if at any point you feel that you are not getting the thing or you just need a more deeper perspective, so please let me know for the same. And in the moreover, one more thing, in the distinction between either be the supervised learning or the unsupervised learning, so supervised or unsupervised ko hum as a layman kaise check kar sakte hai ki ha maine koi data set liya ye supervised hai unsupervised hai. So jo supervised hota hai uske andar hamare paas labeled input aur output hote hai data ke, but unsupervised mein nahi hote. तो अगर आप किसी डेटा सेट से डील कर रहे हो तो एज अ लेमैन यू कैन से हाँ ठीक है आई एम गोइंग विद अ सुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग एंड इफ यू आर नॉट डीलिंग विद द डेटा सेट यू कैन से यस आई एम गोइंग विद अ लाइक लेबल डेटा सेट आई शुड मेंशन लेबल डेटा सेट देन यू कैन से दैट आई एम डीलिंग विद अ अनसुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग. लेट्स मूव अहेड टू द मशीन लर्निंग प्रॉब्लम्स. द फर्स्ट कम इज डेटा गैदरिंग, द सेकेंड इज डेटा प्री प्रोसेसिंग. प्री प्रोसेसिंग का मतलब है क्लीन करना, जैसे कि हमने अपने रीसेंट प्रोजेक्ट में क्लीन करा था डेटा को. देन कम्स टू फीचर इंजीनियरिंग, आई विल एक्सप्लेन व्हाट फीचर इंजीनियरिंग इज. द फोर्थ इज एल्गोरिथम सिलेक्शन एंड ट्रेनिंग. मशीन लर्निंग में हमारे पास काफ़ी सारे एल्गोरिथम्स होती है, अब उस एल्गोरिथम्स में हमें चूज क्या करना है वो हमें देखना पड़ता है. अगर मैं आपको एक ब्रॉड परस्पेक्टिव दूँ इवन अबाउट द एल्गोरिथम्स, वी हैव द लीस्ट स्क्वायर एल्गोरिथम, we have Newton's method, the gradient descendant. ये सारे algorithms आपको अभी समझ नहीं आएगी, but जैसे जैसे आप start करोगे you will get to know ठीक है machine learning के अंदर ये algorithms होती है and how we are supposed to train our model depending upon different algorithms. Data gathering. Data gathering का मतलब क्या होता है, या तो manual हो सकता है, it could be a manual labeling for the supervised learning. बिकॉज सुपरवाइज के अंदर आपकी एसोसिएटेड होते हैं डेटा सेट्स कि लेबल डेटा सेट है या नहीं है. इन द वेरी बिगनिंग द फर्स्ट प्रोजेक्ट विच वी डेमोन्स्ट्रेटेड दैट वॉज अ लेबल डेटा सेट. इट कुड बी अनलेबल्ड एज वेल एंड द अनलेबल डेटा सेट विल कम अंडर द अनसुपरवाइज्ड वंस. द सेकेंड थिंग इज डेटा प्री प्रोसेसिंग. डेटा को प्री प्रोसेस कैसे करते हैं, इन द राइट हैंड साइड यू कैन सी अ फोटोग्राफ एंड अ ग्राफ फॉर द सेम. इसमें कुछ अलग लग रहा है आपको इन द फोटोग्राफ? कैन यू सी द डिफरेंस, एनी डिफरेंस इन द लाइक इन द दिस एप्पल्स विच आर पोर्ट्रेटेड ओवर द स्क्रीन? So basically, yeah, you may continue. Very true. The odd one out is above the main line. So in the data processing, it's the main concept. अगर हमें लगता है जब हम प्रोसेस करते हैं डेटा को तो हम चेक करते हैं इज देयर समथिंग रॉन्ग इन द डेटा और इज इट देयर, इज देयर एनी मिसिंग वैल्यू, एनी आउटलायर्स, एनी बैड इनकोडिंग, और उसको हमें रिमूव करते हैं और इधर में फिक्स इट. That comes your data pre-processing or your data cleaning. Jaise ki we used dot filna and in the braces we have used zero. Matlab jo values hamari match nahi karegi ya jo values exist nahi karegi uski jagah we will replace zero. So it is something a part of your data pre-processing. The second is the feature engineering. Feature engineering is a concept you should be aware of. So in the feature engineering, it is more about extracting more information from the existing data, not adding new data, but making it more useful. So how you can make it more useful within your present data? It could be variable transformation or feature creation. Let's have a more deeper view in the feature engineering. So for example, A feature is an individual measurable property of a phenomena being observed. Let's take this. So, जब आप डेटा सेट से डील करते हो, you can use feature engineering as well. In the feature engineering, you can just classify some things. It could be a spam emails or features. For example, अगर मैंने ये लिखा है, I can apply the feature engineering and just convert it into 203. These all are the pre-processed thing which I provided to it. That is 0 to English or 1 to Spanish. आप कोई भी अगर string को लिखते हो, उसमें changes करते हो, तो ऐसे आप encoding या ये सब performance कर सकते हो, through the feature engineering. उसके बाद हमारा main concept आता है, मैंने machine learning के बारे में बताया, I told what machine learning is. We have supervised, we have unsupervised, we have reinforcement. But हर एक के अंदर algorithms होती है. अब हम algorithms कैसे use करेंगे? तो पहले हमें ये देखना पड़ेगा कि इसके अंदर कौन से algorithm होती है. In the supervised, we have these algorithms, that is the linear classifier, naive bias, support vector machine SVM, decision tree, random forest, k-nearest. And in the unsupervised, we have PCA, k-means, with these are used in a very broad way out, matlab bahut zyada use hoti hai. We have the reinforcement, the q-learning, and this one. So, ye sari jo hai, humari, sari algorithms hai, jo present hoti hai. हर एक पर्सपेक्टिव के अंदर बट पहले आपको प्रोजेक्ट पे देखना पड़ता है एंड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दैट यू विल यूज द एल्गोरिथम फॉर एग्जांपल इफ आई से यू हैव ओके लेट्स टेक एन एग्जांपल आई एम चेकिंग आउट विद डिफरेंट फोटोग्राफ्स एंड इन द फोटोग्राफ्स लेट्स टेक दोज फोटोग्राफ्स आर ऑफ डिफरेंट कमोडिटीज And I want as an output after applying the things, okay. So in this commodity, which one is a household commodity? उसके अंदर हम photographs से deal करेंगे या नहीं करेंगे? Because जो data set इसमें तो हमने photographs ली है. So जो algorithm use होगी, should it come under the supervised, unsupervised or the reinforcement? It's a question. You could answer me back. Is the question clear or should I repeat it again?
Yeah, repeat the question, please.
Okay, for example, I have taken a data set and the data set is about commodities. And I just have to check that either is this commodity is household commodity or not. Or you can say in any, we are dealing with images here. Let me clarify. So we are dealing with images and I just have to check it out. Either is this image have these perspectives or not? So will it come under the supervised, unsupervised or the reinforcement? Isn't it clear?
Yeah, I think question is clear to everybody. Someone has replied to reinforcement.
Okay, so I was just checking the screen.
Yeah, people are responding.
Okay, apologies. Yeah, reinforcement. So basically, it's like you just have to check it out ki jo hamara data set hai, wo kya hai, aur kaise hum deal out karte hai uske saath. Reinforcement could be there, but in the prior, it should be in the supervised because a data set is associated and it is a labeled one. So let's move ahead. That is,
I think Eva, at this point, I think people have a question mark because why someone is writing reinforcement?
क्योंकि
अगर मान लो कि मैंने एक टेबल दिखाया है इन द पिक्चर एंड आई वांट टू प्रेडिक्ट इट एज अ टेबल और समथिंग एल्स लाइक कार उस केस में हमें क्या करना चाहिए इज इट अ सुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग कांसेप्ट और इज इट अ रीइंफोर्समेंट
सर आई बिलीव इट शुड कम अंडर सुपरवाइज्ड वन बिकॉज़ सर जो लेबल हमारा डेटा सेट होगा वो लेबल्ड होगा अगर हम किसी भी चीज से स्टार्ट करते हैं ना सर विद द बेसिक थिंग हमें सबसे पहले ये देखना चाहिए कि उसमें डेटा सेट किस तरह से इन्वॉल्व हुआ है अगर इमेजेस है और वो लेबल्ड है तो वो सुपरवाइज्ड होगा लेबल्ड नहीं है तो अनसुपरवाइज्ड होगा और उसके अंदर अगर हमारे एक्सटर्नल फैक्टर्स या एनवायरनमेंट मैटर करता है तो इट शुड बी कम अंडर रीइंफोर्समेंट
Pardon, repeat, please. Reinforcement wala part, please explain again.
Sure, sir. So, sir, basically, at first, we need to be very clear about the data set, what we are using. If we are using a labeled data set, so it will come under supervised. If it's unlabeled, that is unsupervised. And if we are talking about the reinforcement, if the external factors or the environment is changing, like agar environment ki wajah se hamara data mein change aa raha hai ya kisi bhi factors mein change aa raha hai, toh it will come under reinforcement. So, sir, in this, I just provided a commodity. I said the images are there. The images are of commodities and it is a labeled data set because images are there and those are labeled images. Tabhi hum check kar sakte hai. So, it should come under supervised.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Then comes the algorithm selection and training. So what is algorithm selection or training? हमने देखा कि हमारी तीन चीज़ें मेन होती है सुपरवाइज्ड अनसुपरवाइज्ड और रीइन्फोर्समेंट बट हम चेक कैसे करेंगे सबसे पहले हमारा गोल होता है गोल ऑफ ट्रेनिंग मेक द करेक्ट प्रिडिक्शन एज ऑफन एज पॉसिबल बहुत बार हमें खुद भी प्रिडिक्शन करनी पड़ती है उस डेटा सेट को लेकर बिकॉज डेटा एनालिसिस के अंदर इफ़ यू गो विद एक्सप्लोरेटरी डेटा एनालिसिस इट इज़ नॉट जस्ट अबाउट कि इससे आउटपुट क्या आएगा बट उससे हम फ्यूचर आउटपुट भी प्रिडिक्ट कर सकते हैं एंड इट्स अ वेरी गुड यूज ऑफ डेटा साइंस अगर आपके पास पास्ट की स्टैटिस्टिक्स है इन द फर्स्ट प्रोजेक्ट वी वर हैविंग द स्टैटिस्टिक्स स्टैटिस्टिक्स से हमें एक आइडिया मिल जाता है क्या हमारे पास वे आउट आया है अब तक और इसी वे आउट के साथ अगर हम चले इन द फ्यूचर इन द अपकमिंग 5 to 10 years दैट कुड बी द आउटपुट सो जस्ट प्रिडिक्ट एंड एडजस्ट दीज टू थिंग्स आर These two things should be a foremost concern. Just predicting the data and adjusting it again and again, depending upon the evaluation and comparing solutions. So making predictions. Predictions हम कैसे make करेंगे? एक हमारा training phase होता है, एक हमारा prediction phase होता है. In the training phase, we have the labels, we have samples. Sample is the data set. We will feature the extraction, the features, and machine learning model. Machine learning model में हम algorithms apply करेंगे. एल्गोरिदम डिपेंडिंग अपॉन आर डेटा सेट आर रिक्वायरमेंट्स डेटा सेट किस तरह का है और इसमें हमें क्या चेंजेस चाहिए उसके अकॉर्डिंग हम देखेंगे कि कौन सी एल्गोरिदम सेट होगी और कैसे हम कर सकते हैं इस पे आगे देन कम्स अ समरी अ ब्रीफ समरी अबाउट मशीन लर्निंग अबाउट द यूज ऑफ डेटा एंड द मेजर थिंग्स यू शुड रिमेंबर और कीप इन माइंड इज supervised, unsupervised and reinforcement because the entire phenomena will just revert about these three keywords. And the steps which do involve in the process is your data gathering, your data pre-processing, your feature engineering, algorithm selection training and making predictions, which I elaborated. Before coming to the deep learning aspects, let's give you a more better perspective about machine learning with one more project. So I will just demonstrate one more project. After we will categorize the deep learning things and we'll get with the industry expert within upcoming 20 to 25 minutes. Let's start with one more project. Okay. Just a second. Is the screen visible?
Yeah.
Okay. So it's a project that is pictorial muscle removal from mammograms. So this project ki I will tell you the entire working. Yeah, humne kaise start kara hai. Iske liye images use hui hai. So you will get the ideas ki agar hamare paas images hai, hum unse deal out kar rahe hai, to hum kaise apne algorithm laga sakte hai, kaise hum OpenCV use kar sakte hai. OpenCV is used for dealing with the images. OpenCV and your iski images. These two modules are used for, in order to deal with your images. So let's start with the algorithm flowchart. Sabse pehle, I have taken 5 images in the concern. These are the 5 images. In these 5 images, what we will deal is, we will just check out how to remove this pictorial muscle. It's a pictorial muscle and we have to remove it. So let's come with the algorithm flowchart. In the algorithm flowchart, we have the mimogram images. These 5 are the mimogram images. Is it right oriented or left oriented? First, we have to check it. And depending upon either it is right oriented or left oriented, we will begin with our proceedings. Because all the images needs to be in a single orientation. If they are not in a single orientation, we can't proceed. Try to just look out on the flow charts or ya khud prepare kara karo flow charts taki aapko pata chale ki aap pure project mein kar kya rahe ho. It is important. If you say it is right oriented, so yes, then we comes with a canny edge detection and obtaining the whole line transform. I will explain this in the project. Ye cheez aapko bahut use aayegi if you will make projects about the images, that is using OpenCV or image detection. It is a project which is based on healthcare. Okay, and if the image is not, then flip the image and obtain the whole line transform, shortlist it, and choose at least area to be removed. So it's a basic flow chart. Let's see out.
So should we maintain a handwritten flow chart or we should maintain a soft copy of flow chart?
So it's absolutely on one's convenience. Like hum dono tarah se rakh sakte hai, but if you can keep it in the soft copy, it's better. Because in the soft copy, you can further update it on your GitHub as well.
Right, right. As well as for future users.
Very true, sir. For the future users. Even these, it is a project which I was working on, keeping a research paper. So it's like, agar aap koi project karte ho, aur aapko lagta hai ki it is worth doing up, so you can even go with the research paper on the same project. It's a healthcare project. तो हमने क्या करा, सबसे पहले वी टुक 5 इमेजेस. ऑल द 5 इमेजेस आर देयर. इसमें हमें पिक्टोरियल, दिस इज द पिक्टोरियल मसल, इसे रिमूव करना है. अब हम कैसे रिमूव करेंगे, दैट्स द फर्स्ट प्रायर कंसर्न. वी स्टार्टेड विद द IPYNB फाइल. IPYNB इज अ जुपिटर नोटबुक. पिक्टोरियल मसल रिमूवल फ्रॉम मेमोग्राम्स. सबसे पहले हमने इंपोर्ट करा लाइब्रेरीज को, इंपोर्टिंग numpy एज np, matplotlib.py plot एज plt. ये हमने विजुलाइजेशन के लिए करा है, एंड अगेन plab. numpy हमने क्यों इंपोर्ट करी, numpy आपकी एरे के लिए यूज़ होता है. मतलब अगर आप कोई भी चीज़ के अंदर numeric यूज़ कर रहे हैं एंड डिटेक्ट कर रहे हो पॉइंट्स को इमेजेस के अंदर, देन यू विल गो विद numpy. As I said that we have taken 5 images. All the 5 images are grayscale. अब grayscale का मतलब क्या होता है, आपके पास दो तरह की images होती है. One is your RGB. RGB is your red, green, blue. The second is your grayscale. This grayscale is in where you can see the pixels into being two form. Either it could be black, either it could be white. So these are your grayscale images. The second what we have done, in order for the algorithm to generalize over all memograms, we first right orient all the images. इसमें कुछ images हैं जो हमारी right oriented है, कुछ images हैं हमारी जो left oriented है. हम सबसे पहले हर एक image को right orient करेंगे, but हम right orient कैसे कर सकते हैं? If you look on the images, आपने देखा होगा कुछ part हमारा image में black है and कुछ part हमारा image में white है. तो keeping this in the concern, जो हमारा black part होगा, it will be pixel 0 and white part would be pixel 1. तो इसके अकॉर्डिंग हम इसे राइट ओरिएंट कर सकते हैं. वी सिंपली कंपेयर द नंबर ऑफ नॉन जीरो पिक्सल्स ऑन बोथ हाफ द इमेजेस. हमने कंपेयर करा दोनों हाफ इमेजेस, मतलब एक इमेज के दोनों हाफ साइड्स पे, कि कौन सा हमारे पास जीरो नॉन जीरो पिक्सल्स है और कहाँ पे हमारे पास जीरो पिक्सल्स है. और उसके अकॉर्डिंग वी जस्ट फ्लिप द इमेज. इन द फ्लिप्ड वी यूज द इफ क्लॉज, दैट्स इफ क्लॉज. एंड उसके बाद हमने फ्लिप कर दिया इमेज को. फ्लिप करने के बाद आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू चेक कि हाँ यार, फ्लिप तो कर दिया हमने, बट ईदर इज इट स्टिल अ आर जी बी और इज इट अ ग्रे. अगर हमारा इमेज जो है इट इज स्टिल इन आर जी बी, आई विल जस्ट कन्वर्ट इट आउट इन द ग्रे स्केल. दैट्स व्हाट आई हैव डन. देन कम्स योर as I said that is images ke andar we have to remove the muscle. अगर आप इस मसल को रिमूव करना चाहते हो तो सबसे पहले हमने कैनी एज डिटेक्शन करा. कैनी एज डिटेक्शन क्या होता है? इफ़ यू विल गो विद हू लाइन ट्रांसफॉर्म, हू लाइन ट्रांसफॉर्म का मतलब होता है एक इमेज के अंदर लाइन्स फॉर्म करना, हू लाइन्स बनाना, और उसका मेन कंसेप्ट जो होता है दैट इज़ वाई इज इक्वल्स टू एम एक्स प्लस सी, जो हम सब जानते हो है. इन अवर 11th एंड 12th स्टैंडर्ड वी हैव लर्न व्हाट इज द इक्वेशन फॉर अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. इट इज वाई इज इक्वल्स टू एम एक्स प्लस सी, एंड इफ एन एंगल इज इन्वॉल्व इट कम्स टू कॉस थीटा एंड आर साइन थीटा. It goes in that way. So similarly, we just took the image, we have created the whole lines, and उसे shortlist करने के बाद we remove this muscle from here. Okay, so at first we have just converted it out like RGB into the grayscale, those concerned. Then we just filtered it out, and Canny and Sobel are used for the Canny edge detection for sketching your lines within the image. Then after sketching your lines, I just checked it out ki hum whole transform kaise karenge. In the whole transform we need three concerns: the distance, angle and point 1 and point 2 from the x axis and y axis. Is image ke andar I have a x axis, I have a y axis, and an angle which is associated from here. Depending upon this angle, I can stretch out multiple lines, but कौन सी हमारी सेट होगी वो हम कैसे चेक करेंगे? जो हमारी पिक्टोरियल मसल है इट इज़ डेंसर, दिस इज़ द मोस्ट डेंस पार्ट एज कम्पेयर टू द रेस्ट ऑफ द इमेज. एंड इफ यू आर सेइंग इट आउट दैट इज़ द मोस्ट डेंस पार्ट, दैट्स द एडवांटेज टू अस टू चेक आउट कि हाउ वी कैन रिमूव दिस आउट. सो वी जस्ट अप्लाई द हो ट्रांसफॉर्म. आफ्टर अप्लाइंग द हो ट्रांसफॉर्म we just checked, okay, we have an angle, we have taken theta and distance all into the major concerns. Then comes the shortlisting of the lines. How one could shortlist the lines? One, we can have the minimum angle, so it's a statement. It's a statement which is being used for the same. कि हम कैसे shortlist कर सकते हैं lines को. उसके बाद कुछ आपके projects होते हैं जिसमें आपको clear होता है कि अगर हम मैक्सिमम एंगल इतना लेते हैं, मिनिमम एंगल इतना लेते हैं, तो हम शॉर्टलिस्ट कर सकते हैं. बट कुछ प्रोजेक्ट में यू हैव टू गो विद हिट एंड ट्रायल मेथड, एंड इट्स अ फैक्ट. अगर आप इमेजेस के साथ डील कर रहे हो, मैं नहीं बता सकती इसे देखकर कि यार कितने एंगल के ऊपर मुझे एग्जैक्ट रिजल्ट मिलेगा. आई कॉन्ट डिटेक्ट इट, सो आई विल जस्ट गो विद द हिट एंड ट्रायल, एंड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द हिट एंड ट्रायल आई कैन शॉर्टलिस्ट अ परफेक्ट लाइन इन ऑर्डर टू रिमूव द पिक्टोरियल मसल फ्रॉम द मेमोग्राम. In this case, I just did the same. I just shortlist the line by taking a random hit and trial method and keeping those clauses in the concern, angle, distance. Then we went with the sky image. I said that this is again a library which you can import from the command prompt, and it is used for the images in order to deal with the images. As our main concern lies in y is equals to mx plus c, एंड इस केस में हम थीटा कंसिडर कर रहे हैं होल लाइन ट्रांसफॉर्म के लिए. तो अगर हम थीटा यूज़ कर रहे हैं तो वी कैन गेट विद साइन थीटा एंड कॉस थीटा, और वो चीज़ मैंने यूज़ करी है इन ऑर्डर टू रिमूव द पिक्टोरियल मसल रीजन फ्रॉम द इमेज, टेकिंग द इंटरसेप्ट दैट इज द एक्स इंटरसेप्ट, वाई इंटरसेप्ट एंड अदर इन द कंसर्न. देन कम्स ऑफ डिस्प्लेइंग द फाइनल रिजल्ट. अगर हम डिस्प्ले कर रहे हैं फाइनल रिजल्ट को, हमने स्टार्टिंग में मैटप्लॉटलिब यूज़ करा था. मैटप्लॉटलिब इज़ अ लाइब्रेरी व्हिच इज़ यूज्ड फॉर विजुअलाइजेशन पर्पस, एंड सिमिलरली आई जस्ट यूज दैट प्लॉटिंग द एक्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द एक्स एंड द वाई एक्सिस, एंड दैट कम्स योर एंटायर कोड फॉर प्लॉटिंग इट आउट, गिविंग द शेप, योर रिस्पेक्टिव एट्रीब्यूट्स एंड जस्ट प्लॉट डॉट शो. सो हियर in a very basic overview you could just get it out ki humne images liye hai, we have taken these libraries, we applied with some things you can say like defining the function, importing cv2 and reading the file, checking it out, either it's a grayscale or the rgb, applying canny detection to check ki hamare pixels kahan pe lie kar rahe hai, kaise hum detect kar sakte hai. We go with the SK image to check the whole transform. Then comes the shortlisting of the lines. We shortlist the lines. हमने रिमूव करा पिक्टोरियल मसल को डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द साइन थीटा कॉस थीटा यू इंटरसेप्ट वाई एन एक्स इंटरसेप्ट विच वॉज एसोसिएटेड विद इन द इमेज देन वी डिस्प्ले द फाइनल रिजल्ट और अगर हम इंडिविजुअल करते हैं डिस्प्ले इमेज मेमो वन पी एन जी तो हमें पूरा रिजल्ट आ जाता है कि हमारी ये सारी होल लाइन्स हुई थी हमने शॉर्ट लिस्ट करा एंड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दैट वी रिमूव द मसल दैट कम्स इन ऑल द केसेज सो इट्स अ प्रोजेक्ट विच इज़ बेस्ड ऑन द हेल्थ केयर एंड I am just showing you the entire project because in the SIG I can tell you ki kaise aap proceed karo cheezon ke sath aap data science mein kaise jao but until and unless aap project khud build nahi karoge ya aap khud go through nahi karoge unke sath you will never be able to get the expertise in the field so it's always required to just check the project understand in your own self kya cheeze isme ho rahi hai कभी भी हम डी एस ओ एल के साथ बिगिन करते हैं बट वी डू इज वी चेक द एडिटर्स कि हाँ ठीक है हाउ द क्वेश्चन इज बीइंग सॉल्व्ड सो ट्राई टू डू दिस यू विल अंडरस्टैंड द थिंग्स एंड जस्ट लर्न द पाइथन बेसिक लाइब्रेरीज दैट इज द पाइथन लैंग्वेज एंड योर लाइब्रेरीज बी एच यूर पांडास नमपाई मैट डॉट लैब सीबॉन दीज फोर लाइब्रेरीज आर द बेसिक विच यू शुड बी अवेयर अबाउट सो लेट्स गो विद द ग्लिम्स अबाउट डीप लर्निंग And then we will be having with the industry expert. It's been more about 1.5 hours. So let's do it in 15 minutes. And then we will have with the industry expert. Though you can ask your questions about the same. How an experience is going to be in the industry and everything. So let's wrap it up first. So in these images, we recently deal with the images. And I just want you to just express your views. Okay, after getting with that project, what views you have. About machine learning or deep learning perspectives. What do you think? Could I have it some views? It could be any view. Either you liked it, either you didn't like it, or what you think like could you be able to proceed with the same field is there any interest you created in the same
Eva, what is the question you are asking please repeat again
yes sir so I'm just asking about like till now getting a basic idea about data science and machine learning and getting with these projects what your experience lies in like Are you able to get with the field and what you think? Like, is it a field with which you want to continue ahead and your interest lies in?
Yeah, for me, it is a great field actually. But for new people, they have to dive in and they have to enjoy the taste of this field. From outside, you cannot feel how to swim. You have to dive in water and enjoy the swimming.
Yes, sir.
This is the case in AI. It is a beautiful and, of course, the demanding and unavoidable area now for everybody, every engineer. If you are not in AI, then in future you will vanish. You will not be in engineering profession. Okay, so everybody has to do it. There is no option. But yes, you have lot of options to choose where you should go in AI. It is a big domain. Like the Python programming language, that itself has a lot of potential, and that is the basic. And once you start with the programming language like Python or R, then you can go for implementing in through other tools. Okay, so guys who are just watching this concept for the first time, you have to try it yourself. There is humongous code in the net. It is not that you have to define every code from the scrap. Most of the codes are there in the libraries. And you have to know how to use the libraries. That's it. So for that only you have to try it out and see how beautiful is the idea. That's it. What I mean to say.
I agree, sir. It's a very good feel if you will get it out. And even the code, you can get the codes on the, that is, I guess multiple websites are there to which you can get the code, but just get a basic idea. That how the working is going up, just understand the code. That is what is required in this field. On the Stack Overflow, you can get thousands of code. But just make sure you understand them. So let's have a basic idea about the deep learning. So what is deep learning? Let's have these three photographs. All these three are cats. That's what a human perspective will see. Okay, we have three cats. But if we go with the perspective of a data scientist or a person who is dealing with deep learning, what he will see is every single image is dealing with a different aspect, either be it occlusion, diversity in the image, deformation, or lighting variations. Because he is going to deal out with the image and make the changes in the image as per the requirements. So that's a difference which lies in a normal human being and a data scientist, that how you are going to deal with the images. Here comes your three concepts. In a deep learning, it is broadly the three things which you need to be aware about. That is the ANN, CNN, and the RNN. So what is ANN, what is CNN, and the RNN? So ANN is your, like if I go in the broad way out, you can see the first model of artificial neural network is proposed in 1943, which looks way back, but we need not to go about its history. Because if we are making a project, we need to know ki haan agar ANN use hua hai, to why it is being used and what is the use in it. So it is used if you are going to have tabular data or the text data. For that way, you will use the ANN in your project. And coming up to CNN, CNN is your convolutional neural networks. It is the thing I should suggest to you, agar aap deep learning se start karte ho, to CNN ke saath start karna, wo kaafi easy hoga, proceed karna aapke liye. CNN ke liye, in the last year, I made a project. It was sign language recognition. And I made this project within IEEE itself. So CNN is a broad field and in which you will be dealing with the image data. And in the RNN, you will deal out with the sequence data. So har ek data jab aap deal karte ho, even in the deep learning, you have fields, CNN, RNN, ANN, and every single field define a different payout for the same. Coming to the loss functions, so I won't go deep into this because I guess most of the people are newcomers for this field. So I'm just telling you a layout ki haan theek hai, agar deep learning ke aap saath jaate ho, to ye sab cheeze hoti hai which exist in the same. So let's give me with this. Okay, let's take this example. It's an image of a cat, but in the digital representation of the image, what you will see is this. And what is it exactly? So it is the classification of this image which we have used by the algorithms for the discrete data. Har ek image jo hai, that is associated with your kernel in the backend, and by applying the convolution you could get these scale values which are there in this image, and every single value is depending upon the convolutional kernel. Like we can pick up a specific pattern for the image. And even in this particular example which we have taken, we will demonstrate the detection of the horizontal and the vertical edges, which is used in the image using the appropriate kernels. It's an example of deep learning and particularly for deep neural networks. So in the deep neural networks, here you can see this image has been classified in this way out in association with the CNN and the networks. And moreover, these are the operation that is a convolution operation which we have applied. So what is the use of convolution operation, or why we are applying it? So convolution is an operation that is performed on an image to extract the features from it and applying a smaller tensor called the kernel. So in this image, we have applied a smaller tensor, that is the kernel. Like it could be like a sliding window over the image, and through which we can carry out our operations. In short, I will just give a basic overview, keeping the time and everything in the concern, so you could have an idea ki hum changes kaise kar sakte hai ek image ke andar. So ye image thi, humne convolution operation lagaya is image ke andar. We dealt with this array and we have just converted this input as this feature image. So these all are the interesting features you can go with in this field. But it's a very true thing that you have to dive within, as Parthi sir said. I can just give an overview in 2 hours. I can't give you the entire, everything. But yes, my entire motive lies in motivating you people to carry with this field. So one more concept comes here, that is the pooling operation. So what is a pooling operation? This is a data set I have, and I want to go with 2x2 pooling, that is 2x2 max pooling. So there is two pooling. One is max pooling, the second is the min pooling. Pooling on kyun karte hai? To reduce the dimensionality of the data set. Ab iske agar max pooling kar rahe ho, to max pooling ka meaning hai, in all these four cells, I will just check out what's the maximum value. Here I have 20, here I have 30, similarly 112 and 37. So by applying the max pooling, I could just assure you that it makes the network invariant to small transformation and distortion for the same translations. So what we observed in the deep learning, it's like taking an input, using the convolutional layer, non-linear functions, pool karna, humne pool kaise kara, humne maximum pooling lagai uske andar, humne kernel ke through we could get an array and just make the changes for the same. So the feature extraction was there, and after the feature extractions, we have flattened it and fully connected those layer. That's the classification. Har ek image ke liye humne extract kari cheeze, usse connect kara, and it comes in your classification. Okay, so one more concept is there. If we have a label cat and we are going with a supervised problem, it's a supervised problem. We have this cat and it has a label cat. It is like informed earlier. So after applying the convolutional network, the prediction comes dog. So can it be a dog or it can't be a dog? Of course, it can't be a dog. So though the convolutional network, you can check that either the prediction is true or false. In this scenario, the prediction comes out to be a dog, which is a false prediction. That's how we apply the loss function in it. I guess some things must be looking out to be out of the way or out of the box. But yeah, you need to have an idea, which I just want, though this is IG. Then comes again one image. We have again the supervised problem here. The label is cat. I applied the convolutional network. The prediction comes out to be cat. It's a true. So in the loss function, I will have a value as 0. Because the statement exists as a true statement. So deep learning is possibly going to stay here. AI, deep learning, your data science, and beat machine learning, they will surely stay here. Because in every single industry, data is being used. Even in our day-to-day life, we have lots of data which we deal with. We have architectures for the data. We have frameworks, the TensorFlow, Keras, Torch, even like in the power, that is the industry, the big industry or the players which we have, they have huge requirements. Because in every single industry, we have data and we do know how to deal out with the data. So let's come to a conclusion, and after this basic conclusion, we will be just having a speaker with us. So in the conclusion, machine learning algorithms learn from the data to find hidden relation. Just try to make prediction interact with the world. A model could be a good model, it could be a bad model, it doesn't matter. Just make sure you are just trying with the models. You are beginning with the data gathering, data collection, visualization techniques, then move to machine learning, check the supervised and unsupervised image processing, speech recognition is also there, language processing is there, then comes with your deep learning part. Just give me 5 minutes, we are going to have our guest speaker here. So just give me 5 minutes, I will be just back with the guest speaker. गुड इवनिंग रोहित. We are glad to have you here with us. So Rohit, we just want a brief introduction about yourself, like how you proceeded with your journey. And as presently you're serving at Microsoft. So how the experience have been and being an ex-intern in IndiaMART and similarly for the Bharti Airtel. Could you just give us a brief overview?
Yeah, first of all, thank you, Eva, for having me. And I hope you all are doing good and are safe. So coming on to the introduction. Hello everyone. My name is Rohit Kaushik. Currently I'm working as a developer in Birlasoft and working on our technology SAP ABAP. And previously I have done internships in Bharti Airtel and IndiaMART as well.
That's amazing to listen, Rohit. Even we have a branch counselor with us today, Mr. Parthi sir. So sir, here we have the speaker. So Rohit,
Mr. Rohit, thank you for coming and it is a great time to listen to you. So we are all very anxious to listen to what you address and what suggestions you give to our young developers for the future.
Yeah, thank you. It's truly my pleasure.
Welcome to the forum, sir.
Wonderful. So Rohit, could we have an idea like how you proceeded with this field and how the things went up?
Yeah, definitely. So guys, like I started working on data science in my third year, I suppose. And for all of you guys, like I know when I started it, so I can say like in starting, it seems like very intimidating to see such a lot of heavy words like machine learning, deep learning and all of these algorithms. But I would like to say that when you start working on it, it seriously are very like, it's not very difficult, I would say. So if you start building and practicing all on it, it's basically all about data, like how you are good with data, your problem solving skills, your thinking ability, your communication skills. So after all, I would like to say that it's very not difficult to start.
I do agree. So Rohit, you were there in the Bharti Airtel and IndiaMART. So what roles and responsibilities were there which you continued with?
Yeah, definitely. So in Bharti Airtel, I got an opportunity to work there as an intern in the networking field. So there I got a project on MPLS. It's multi-protocol label switching. It's more kind of a networking, I would say, because you know that Airtel is more into telecommunication services. So there I got an opportunity to work on this profile. And with the help of my supervisor, I did perform very good. And it's all basically like routing. Whenever you send the data from one source to another. And in this, the service which is provided by Airtel is like they protect your data while sending from, like if you want to send the data from one place to another, like from one office to your another office and you want it to be encrypted and to be very fast. So it deals with all kind of that data. And meanwhile, they maintain their client details, like what hardware required they want, all these in a Metasoft software. And also like they maintain their databases also. And after all, after providing the services, they ensure that your service is well equipped and you are well satisfied with your services. Like if you need any problem in settling down or your wire, like if you are getting any trouble with the wire connections, so they all are ready to help you. And with the IndiaMART, it was more related to data science part. I got there as a web scraping intern. So my day-to-day task there was, I was given a duty to scrap the data. So scraping here means that you are extracting the data from various online sources and your data can be your structured as well as unstructured. So here structured means that you are getting a data in a tabular form, like rows and columns. And in terms of unstructured, you are getting a data in form of images, videos, as well as text or numbers. So my work there was to extract the data from the sources and it involves your Python language. And I would say literally I made like around 50 to 60 codes in whole journey duration that on everyday basis they are required. Like you have to make 3 to 4 codes every day, which are required for one website to scrap. So that was my whole task in that.
Okay. So like you have served as an intern as well. Even one of our members was asking for the same, like, could we get an internship for data science? You could have, like, guidance from Rohit here that he has worked in IndiaMart as a web scraper. Even guys, if you have any questions, you can proceed with the same. Any question regarding the data science? Rohit, one more question I do have. What are the preferred languages one should support?
Okay. So, like, I would be a little bit biased here because I like Python very much. Because it's very easy, or you would say the syntax is very easy. It's because it has a very versatile language. You can use it if you don't like preferred, like on data science part. You can use it on web development as well. Also game development and like desktop GUI also. So preferably as a data scientist, you should be like familiar with the two languages, Python as well as R. If you are familiar with both the languages, then it's very good for you because you can adjust it every industries. Some industry like prefer more Python, some industry prefer more R. But overall, I would say like most of the industries are leaning towards Python. If you are Python, you are good to go.
That's amazing. Rohit, here we have a question. Sumit is asking, apart from data visualization, what all duties does a data analyst perform? Like being a data analyst, what all duties we are supposed to go with?
Okay. So like data visualizations come to at the end part. Initially, you were given a task. You were given a task. Like problem is given to you. Your basic task is to find the solution to that problem. And how would you find that? You will be provided with the data, the past data. And after analyzing the past data, past trends going on, you have to make predictions that in future, like the past data has been proceeding, in future also it will proceed in the same way. So you have to work like that. Initially, the data is provided to you. After data is provided, you have to perform EDA. We call it as EDA. It stands for Exploratory Data Analysis. So it means like you have to clean the data. Cleaning means here whenever data is given to you, like almost 99% the data is not clean. It's your responsibility to clean the data. And how would you clean the data? There are some of the commands you can follow, like there are missing values. So instead of missing values, you can remove that entire row. Or if you want that row to have an unbiased value to it by seeing all the structures. And after performing EDA, your main task is to find the correlations between parameters which you are provided with. And after finding the correlations, your next task is to be find the algorithms. So I would like to say that on the machine learning algorithm parts, like you have heard, there are like many machine learning algorithms, whether be it supervised or unsupervised. So like don't get confused in these two terms, because every time whenever you make a model, like whenever we talk about algorithms, we make model onto it. So whenever you're making a model, you need some of the algorithms. So as a data scientist, you always need to perform and see like which all algorithms are good to go. Because you can't say after seeing a problem that this algorithm works well or this algorithm works well. You have to analyze. And after after passing the data to every algorithm, you have to make accuracy rate. Like which after sending the data to which machine learning algorithm, the accuracy is higher. And after doing this, then comes your visualization part. You have to visualize the data because visualization is important. It's like very crucial important. Some people think like it's not very useful to us. But as a data scientist, you really need visualization tools. And I would need to tell you why. Because whenever a client wants some information from you, like your end, you are given a problem and the problem is given to you by a client itself. So at the end, they ensure that you give them a solution in a proper way. And since a data scientist, you are very familiar with the coding parts and data visualization, machine learning algorithms. But try to think on the client side. They are not at all familiar with all those like technical parts. So you need to convey the message to them. Like all you find some insights, useful insights, and you want to show that to them. So you can done it by data visualization, like form of pie charts, pie graphs, histograms. They are very useful in order to convey the message to your client or stakeholder. So at that point of time, data visualization is very important too. And in data visualization, there are some of the Python libraries which you can work on like Seaborn or Matplot. But nowadays, what I have seen the trend is people are more focused toward tools for data visualization. And that tools are your Tableau or Power BI. Like both are good to go. Both are really like very easy to understand and they are more easy than coding. So you can go to that softwares and use the visualization part. And here comes your communication skill as well. You have to communicate your data, your solution to a stakeholder. So yeah, that's the whole process you have to follow.
I do agree, Rumbe. That's been a like huge process that how one is supposed to start and like taking it entirely. One more question I have is like presently we are having with the students who are in second year or in the third year and they want to start their data science field. In the entire SIG, I was able to give them an outlook about the projects and how they can go it. But as per you, what should be the entire roadmap which lies in data science? How they should start and to the end, it should be the map or resources you can prefer, the resources which you preferred, the certifications for data science, machine learning or deep learning.
Yeah, got it. So guys, you can start by building the projects. Like project is very useful for a data scientist. Because sometimes the company, but sometimes you don't have an experience as a data scientist and you want to pursue your dream to become a data scientist. So what they see you in is your projects. Like they are very focused over the projects. If you do a really good project, like not the project which are very easily available on the net or you can find the code there as well. And for the project also, I would like to suggest there is a site like Coursera, edX, where there are very good projects. And also the courses also, you can do it. Like one such course is, I have think is like IBM, Professional Certificate for Data Science, or University of Michigan. They are like a really good courses you can work upon. And apart from that, you can work on hackathons, like there are so many hackathons, or like competitions. So in terms of competition, I would like to suggest you, there is a site known as Kaggle. Like it's a very good for data scientists, because there are very same people like you, which they, Kaggle is a platform where they give you a problem and you have to find the solution to that. And they are also very like very huge prizes also, because here in the community, the people from student are also participating as well as the professional, very high level people are also there in the competition. So you have to tough very hard. And like starting all, if you're starting as a initially, you go to a Kaggle site, create your account and start building your projects there. And also there is a very first competition also, I would say it's a Titanic survival competition, very basic one competition. Like if you want to see like how data scientist projects are like or what processes you have to follow, which I already told you, you can go through that project. I would like to give you a glimpse of that project. Like it's a project you have provided with the data. Like everyone has seen the movie Titanic, I would say. Like it's a very famous movie and very well-known movie. So there Titanic, you have seen like at the end, almost all the people die. Some of the people are left. So this is the problem they have given to you at the Kaggle site. Like you have to predict how much people will survive and which are not. And how will you predict from the data itself? They will provide the data to you as well as. So data, they have some parameters like age, or like which compartment you were in, like lower end of the compartment, lower end of the ship or the upper end. Because at the lower end, you have most of the chance that you would be killed, because at the lower end, like water comes first and at the upper end, they comes later. So you can drive through the boat as well as. So like these are the problems, very common problems you can solve and see like how good you are at data scientist or what you need to improve. So yeah, that's the whole thing.
Thank you so much, Rohit. I guess we could have an idea through this, how as a data scientist, how the entire structural layout lies with. And if you have any questions, it's to everyone, you can ask for the same. Rohit, do you think like there are some specific skills that a data scientist should have with? Any specific skills?
Yeah, if you talk about skills, I would say like you would be good at coding. Like people would be like very intimidating or like in a fear of saying like coding is not a very good part of them. But as a data scientist, you would be good at coding. And coding here means like if you work on a Python, there are some of the libraries I would like to focus on you. There are libraries like Pandas, NumPy, scikit-learn, seaborn, matplotlib. They all are libraries which data scientists are more focused towards. Like other than that, you can literally be like, no, you cannot touch other parts, but these are the things which you're literally good at. So start building your like Python skills. And apart from Python, you need SQL also, SQL. So SQL is like very important in the starting, because like whenever you're getting a data, there is some sort of database where the data is stored. And after all, you have to retrieve the data. And the best tool for that is SQL. So like you would be good at SQL, good at Python, as well as after that, like if you can done these things, machine learning algorithms, you can do it very easily. That's not a very difficult part. And like EDA also, exploratory data analysis. After you like know some bits of Python, then you can come to EDA part, exploratory data analysis, where you try to focus on like which all data you require, which all data you have to remove from your database and all those things. So like basically I would say Python, good to go. Your SQL also, machine learning algorithms. And at last, I would say communication skills also matters a lot, because you have to convey all the data to your stakeholders or clients. So that's all the main skills you need to go to pursue your dream as a data scientist.
I do agree, Rohit. I do agree. It was wonderful. We have one more question from Aditya. Do we need to be proficient with cloud services like AWS, that is Amazon Web Services, or Azure for data science? Like, is it a necessity?
Okay. So initially, you would not require AWS for cloud services. But as you proceed further, like after 1 or 2 years, if you perform very good at data scientist parts, then you would be requiring AWS. Because AWS is, like we all know now, is a very booming part, and all the data is required there. It's a cloud service. You store the data there. But initially, I would not recommend start with AWS. Start with other things like Python and all, data wrangling part, not with AWS.
Alright, I understood. It's wonderful to hear. If anyone else is having questions, please do ask. Any questions it could be. You could unmute yourself or ask in the chat box.
Yeah, guys, feel free to communicate your questions.
And Rohit, I have a question. Like many people do think about, because data science have a huge scope in India, but abroad as well. So if you think like keeping data science for the abroad way out, could you suggest like how can one proceed for that?
Yeah, definitely. So like, yeah, data scientists like in other countries, I would like to say like USA or UK, all the European countries as well, like Germany, France, they have very good scope for data scientists. But if you need to do your master's like there to pursue your dreams, or after, or like there would be two options. First option would be to work here as a data scientist 2 to 3 years. Then you can contact their like the you can contact there with the company, and you can go there, work there as well. Another part is that you can do masters in data analytics parts, and then you can work there. So like both of them has a really good scope, and you can work there very well. And moreover, the salary part also, like there is a very good salary amount you would be giving. And in terms of growth and scope, like, yeah, because most of the good companies like Amazon, Google, Facebook, they have their headquarters at USA. So it's a really good opportunity to work if you get a chance to work there. So that would be really great.
I agree. And if one wants to go there, the criteria would be the GRE and those ones?
Yeah. So if you want to do like masters there, you have to follow certain criteria. Like specifically for the USA, you have to, you should have your good GPA. Like GPA in the sense CGPA for India. You are doing like currently you are doing like bachelor's, right? All. So you should have good like around 8 or above 8 to pursue your dream in USA. And apart from that, you have to give your GRE also. Like GRE is a test which only mostly USA institutes recommend. And it's a paper which your include quants as well as verbal. So you have to good at it. And apart from that, you have to be good at extracurricular activities also if you want to pursue your master's in abroad. And like, yeah, USA mainly, if I talk about, they would take your holistic approach rather than only your GPA or your internship parts. So if you are like, if you have low GPA also, you can build up your profile very good. And letter of recommendation also matters a lot. So that these all things are required for the masters.
Yeah, I understood. I guess after listening this out that we all need to have a GPA more than 8, we should be going ahead in the same way.
Yeah, yeah.
But we should have this. So one more question is there, Rohit, by Isha Nehwal. What mathematical topics do we specifically need to be good at for machine learning? I guess she is asking about the statistical part or the algorithms, that do we need to be have a good expertise in the machine learning, that is the algorithms and the statistics, or if yes, so how we may go for the same.
Okay, so yeah, I would say you have to be good at maths. Like if you have taken all the courses in BTech, like calculus, linear algebra and all of those topics, then it would be perfect for you. Because the machine learning algorithms, someone can only do a theory part also, but if you have to go deeper into that, you would be requiring maths, like statistics. Like most of the main topics are statistics, your linear algebra, calculus, all these topics are really helpful if you are familiar with these topics. So because all machine learning parts is all about maths, like how maths can take things and give you output. So yeah, you should be good at maths.
Okay, so we need to be good at maths.
Yeah.
Understood. So is there any other question if anybody wants to ask? Okay, we have one more question. That is, Sumit is asking, is it difficult for a non-CS or IT grads to get a job with data science? If we are not having CS or IT as our, that is a subject in our engineering the stream, can we get it, a job in data science ahead?
Okay, so initially I would say it would be a little bit hard if you are not from CS or IT background, but not impossible. Because if you are good at your skills you are possessing and you can showcase your skills, like in your resume, you can showcase you have done a lot of projects, you have done a lot of very fruitful certifications, and you can express yourself there. Yes, you can do your part as a data scientist. So yes, definitely you can get a part in data scientist. But yeah, as compared to CS and IT, they are more comfortable in coding as well, as because like non-CSIT people are a little bit afraid of the coding part. So if you are good at coding as well, you can easily get the job. That's not an issue.
Okay, that's amazing. So you need not to be worried about if we are not from CS or IT, even being from other fields, you can get a job. You just have to push yourself harder. Except this, can we have some more questions? It was truly wonderful, Rohit, to have you here today with us, because you give an entire glimpse that these languages one should be proficient with, and that's your journey, the journey which you have followed. It's been in that way out. If we could have some questions, that would be wonderful. Else, we will be just wrapping the session soon, within few minutes.
Yeah, Eva, I have one question.
Yes, Richard.
First of all, hi Rohit sir. Thank you for coming.
Yeah. Hello, Rachit.
Sir, I have one question. Like for the machine learning object detections, basically when we are detecting something real time basis, so there is a few parameters which depends upon your hardware, like RAM, processing, graphical processing unit, and all that thing. So what, like if I am running one of the code, object detection code or real-time basis, and my computer or my CPU specifications for that code, because the data set is so large that the CPU processing is very, very slow. So can we deploy something like on the cloud, so that cloud, the particular model uses the cloud services for the processing, and then we can deploy that in the main home hardware. So is that anything possible in machine learning?
Yeah, yes, definitely, Rajat. So like normally we run Python code in PyCharm or Jupyter itself. But if you want to perform with large data set, you can go up with Colab. Like I would definitely recommend Colab, because I mostly work with Colab itself. Because your local machine couldn't handle so much large amount of data. So in order to handle that large amount of data, you can work on Colab. it's a Google-based services, which is free of cost for everyone. You have to just create your account there. Like, not an account, your Google account also works there. And you can avail this service free of cost. And they can provide you with more RAM, more processing power, more speed. So you don't have to worry with about any glitches that you face in your local machine, in your Jupyter or PyCharm. So that's a very good thing which Google provides us. And it's a free of cost, so everyone can use it. So I hope that's you got the answer.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Rajit, for the question. And I guess it was a wonderful session to have you here, Rohit, today, because we were just dealing out with data science, machine learning, and deep learning, and you just provided with the entire industry insights for this topic. And you just came within a short period of deadline. So we are glad for you to accept our invitation for this SIG.
Thank you so much. And I would like to say that it's like truly my pleasure that you invited me. And I'm really happy to answer all of your questions. I hope that my suggestions you would take and like grow in future. And if you like, guys, if you have any doubt left and still you are not able to clear that, you can contact me as well as on my LinkedIn profile. Also, I can drop you my email also. You can, if you have any doubt, like feel free to contact me at any point of time.
For sure, Rohit. So I will just drop the LinkedIn and the email over the group itself where you can contact. Moreover, Rohit is also a blogger, I should tell you. He do write articles about data science. So you can ask anything for the same. Yes, Parthi sir.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. Rohit, for this insight. And it is really great that this weekend you have taken your valuable time to spare with us. And we really appreciate if our students can continue interacting with you for getting your knowledge or for extracting your valuable knowledge. Yeah, thanks for coming.
Yeah, thank you so much. No worries. And I really enjoyed the session.
Thank you so much. Could we have a group photograph here? If everyone could open up their cameras and a photograph you could have, that would be really glad. Thank you so much. Devita, can you please take the photograph?
Yeah, Didi, I'm taking.
Thank you, Devita. Devita, is it done?
Yes, Didi, done.
Okay. Thank you so much, Parthi, sir. You just came and spent the time in this SIG, being it a Sunday. And secondly, thank you, Rohit, because we just invited you a few days back and you came within the short notice and gave us the industry insights.
Yeah, no problem in that. Like, I really enjoyed it.
It's our pleasure to have you. And thank you everyone for joining this session. I hope that by this session you could get an industry insights and how one should proceed with Python, even by the projects. Even I will surely suggest you out to go with the projects on your own in the upcoming time being, because building the project is the best way out to learn Python, data science, machine learning, or beat any language.
Yeah,
so
yes,
thank you so
definitely.
Much, guys. Yes, Rohit.
Thank you, Rohit sir, for joining us, taking out time from your busy schedule and mentoring the students of IEEE DGITM. And of course, Eva, so good SIG, so much insightful to know that what is machine learning, how data science and everything works, and looking forward to work upon it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rajit. Even I am glad for your presence in this SIG.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. So let's get with the session. Let's wrap this session. Thank you again.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye, sir. Thank you, sir, for joining.